Hello guys, this is DC Trader here for another week of market review, and this is November 23rd 2020, and it looks to me that this US market wants to go up to above 3582, and it feels good to be a trader right now. All right, and then so basically right now I would like to show you guys how inside, although this is not our market, this is the US market, but this is a software called Bookmap, right? The inside here, you got software wherein buyers and sellers are fighting, you know, that the one that I always explain. So who's leading, who is winning the battle? So just give you an example, you know that buyers were here buying all the way, because the green bubbles are, there are more buyers than sellers. And then of course the sellers tried to push the market down, right? And then what happened is, again, buyers trying to push up, and then of course sellers tried to go down. Where's the target of the sellers? Around this particular area. So basically that they fight until when they reach this level, then they get overwhelmed with all buyers. You see, there's more green bubbles than red bubbles. And then if you take a look at that, what happened, and where are the targets of these buyers? They went above here, they went all straight away up. So that is just an example of how these goes together under price action. So that's about it. So if you take a look at this particular area here, right, actually this, the one that I showed you guys, is only this particular area. I'll just highlight it. The one that I discussed to you guys was just only this particular area, guys. So try to go up, market tried to push down, tried really to push down, and of course they got overwhelmed by buyers over to go up, and now they're trying to go back down again. So, but their target of these buyers are around this particular area, right? So that's about this. And the software called is Bookmap, and this only happens in the US markets, but this is just an example of how it looks like. So that's why this is just the tape reading, if you want to take a look at the tape, but that's for another subject next time. So let us take a look at our markets, guys. And our markets, what did our markets did today? It is, looks like it is going above 7,132, and staying, it looks like it's staying above there, guys, and I like it.
I like it, I love it, I want some more of it.
So basically right now, it looks to me we just, you know, here Friday and then Monday, it looks to me we just open it up, and then it looks like we wanted to break near 7,300. But let's take a look at it. There's a little bit of a but, because take a look at this. This is Friday's candle. Today we got some continuation, right? But near the end of the day, around 11:30, we had a start of a bear micro channel. Oops. Oh, I'm sorry. All right, so that is not so nice, but okay, there's a but again. So we need to stay away from what area? Around this particular area, although we're quite far, right? So tomorrow morning, if we can, if we open around 7,220 and go straight down, then you know we may want to test this particular area, right? But for tomorrow, if we open above 7,244 and go up, then we may be building another micro channel to the upside. So let's take a look at it, because for me it looks like it tried to open, reach around 7,264, broke a little bit higher, then found sellers to push the market down. Now, although it does not mean that it's going to go all the way down, because take a look at this, guys. Overall, guys, we have how many days that we're breaking highs? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 days already. So, of course, this particular area around 7,000, well, where I'm just going to guide this tomorrow, we just don't want to go back to the low of this area here, 7,158, around that area. That's about it. If we can stay above there, guys, then we know we want to stay above. Then this market is trying to go above 7,264. And that is for this particular market. And our next market that we're going to be discussing is AC Energy. And what is AC Energy doing, guys? Oh, yeah. Take a look at that, guys. That is one hell of a stock, guys. Look at that. It's even trying to go.
I like it. I love it.
If we make this one bigger, guys, you know that, okay, there was a little micro channel. Now, this is what I told you guys a while ago on the PSE market. See, you have a little micro channel. But what if tomorrow we open and go straight above? We even tried to go down here and continue like that. Then you know there's a new bull micro channel to go up. Now, of course, you know this has been... For this particular stock, guys, we have how many days we have not yet break any lows yet? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 days, guys. That is good. Now, of course, tomorrow, these two areas are the one that I'll be looking at. 611 and 646. Now, if we go stay above 646, then you know we wanted to go up more. Right, and I'm not so sure until when, but that's my feeling, right? So which means that we are overpowering the seller. There's more buyers than sellers. That's why it looks like, remember on the book map, there's more actually green bubble, right? So but that's about for this particular stock. So these two areas are the one that we're gonna take a look at it, because tomorrow if it opens around here and continues here and stay below 611, then you know this is a micro channel going to the downside, right? That is for this particular stock. Now, the next particular stock that I'll be discussing with you guys is Ali. Now, for Ali, guys, we had a break on a low of Friday, which is not so okay, but overall, right, overall, there's still some good news in the bad news. Take a look at this, guys. So you know that for this particular stock, okay, we had a bear micro channel here, then we tried to go up. We could not go below this 39 level, so we broke here, and then we touches twice. Then today we open up a little bit higher, but we found some sellers trying to retest 3964, which is this area here. And what happens is it found buyers. Thank God there, it found buyers. Now tomorrow, if this does not go back to 3964, guys, then you know it wants to stay above 40, around 40 area. Now if it stays around 40 area, then you know its target is around 40 31, and then it's on its way to its target. And but its main target, guys, is really 44 15. That is good. So tomorrow let's see what happens to the market, because right now it seems to me it tried to here, and then it tried to go, but the problem is it tried to go down here. What's that, right? Yes. So which means the bad thing is that it closed around here though, so there's some gapping down though. So Okay, so that is not so great for Ali because it tried to go up and now it closed here. But let's see. We still have some. As long as it does not reach 38.32, guys, we are okay. We are okay to the upside. The next particular stock that we're going to be discussing is BDO. And BDO today, guys, it actually did a very good continuation, guys. And I love it. What happened was, you know, this was the Friday's market, guys. And today it opened up here and went up to 110, around 110, 18. And then it found sellers. But that's okay. As long as they don't continue this particular micro channel, we could start a new bull micro channel to the upside, guys. And that looks good. Because I think for this particular stock, guys, we still have some room to go up to 114. And that is, I think that's our real main goal there. And then from there, how many days have we been on an up day? Did not break the low. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So around mostly, most stocks have been up for 5 straight days. And that is good. But I think there will be some sellers going to come in, you know, to make this market a little bit more healthier. It's not that I want the market to go down, but that's how price action works, right? There has to be some equal force. So the way I would see it tomorrow, the only way we can reverse this particular downside here is that we can open at 108 and go straight up and even break 1110 to go to 114. But other than that, I think they may want to test this particular area and maybe go back to 102. Maybe there's some people there left behind. Maybe close this little gap here. That's for this particular stock. So the next particular stock is Converge. And what is Converge doing, guys? The way I see Converge is... there is really, now you know that 1680, you know the beginning of the IP, the opening of the IPO, you know there's sellers there pushing it down, sellers pushing it down. It went above there and again, sellers all over at 1680, guys, everything and then trying to push down. Now, does it mean really that it's going to go down? Now, the only thing that I would find is that, okay, if it goes down, we need to take a look at 1650. If it stays, if it could reach there, because that's its new support though. Now, if it could not reach 1650, then you know it wants to go back to 1690 and above. That's what I feel for this particular market, guys. So that's for this particular market, guys. So my feeling is that, okay, this could be a bear micro channel trying to go down. The only way is we need to take a look at it. What happens if it reach 1650? If it could reach there. If it could not, then you know its goal is to go up higher. And of course, from this particular stock, we have never broken the low since this day. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 days, guys. We never broke the low. That is good, guys. That is definitely good for this particular stock. The next stock that we're going to be discussing is DTO. Now, DTO, guys, I'm not so sure why this particular stock, it ain't moving. And remember on Friday, I was kind of happy. It was trying to do a bull micro channel, but it stopped in this particular area. And today, it just opened, hits its head at 646, and dropped all the way down, guys. This is what I'm told you guys. I'm kind of worried around 636. And what happened is, passed through there, And when it reached there, there wasn't any continuing buying, but there were some more selling though. So tomorrow, this area of 627 and 636 is the area that I'll be looking at. Now, if it starts here, open here, and stays above 636, then you know this is a new bull micro channel. But if it opens here and goes straight below 626 and stay below there, then you know there's a continuation to the bear micro channel. Those are the only two scenarios for this particular stock. And then if you take a look at it, we still want it to stay above 617. If it can't stay above 617 and including this particular moving average, then you know they want to go back down to 491, which is a... All right, but let's hope DTO can still go up. Now for FGEN, guys, we are moving an inch higher. Now, of course, in our review last Friday, you know this was a continuation to the downside, and on Friday it went up, remember, and it stopped here, right? And I was telling you guys which are the important price to look at on Monday was 29 and 28.15. And what happened today is it opened at 29, it dropped back here at its closing price on Friday, and it all went back up. So what does that mean? In short, it is starting a new bull micro channel to the upside. Now for me, I feel there may be some continuation to above 29. Now if it goes down, break this level again of 28.50, let's see what happens, right? If it goes a little bit above and goes back down again, then you know it is a start of a bear micro channel. But other than that, the thing that we're going to be watching tomorrow is 28.50 and 29. If we stay above 29, then we know we're going above to 29.50. And if we go above 29.50, then we are ready for breaking and maybe reaching 30, which is the high point of October. That is for this particular stock. And the next stock that we're going to be discussing is HLCM. Now for HLCM, guys, I was kind of like, whoa, what's going on here? Take a look at this guy. Oops, let me clear that one up. Today, it opened here, dropped down here near 7 and went back up. Wow. But let's take a look at it, right? Remember this particular area? We had a bear micro channel to the downside. And of course, I marked this two area here, right? And what happened is on Thursday, it went above there. Then on Friday, I marked this particular level. And then I was telling you guys, okay, we need to take a look at it at around 743 and this area here, 721. So what happened was today, it just touches 742 and drop all the way down, right? And we found buyers around this particular area of 7, right? Now tomorrow, these two levels, 7 and 740 around that area, is important. If we can stay above this particular area of 720, then you know you want this to stay above 742. But what if tomorrow we open here and we drop this around 7 pesos? Let's take a look at it, if it holds or not. If it does not hold, then you know this is a bear channel going to the downside and there's a continuation. That's how you will take a look at it. Other than that, it looks like this particular area may be building a range And why could this be building a range, guys? Let's take a look. Because we have just broken this particular level here. So it could be getting some more buyers here, right? Sellers could be trying to push down, right? They want to go back cheaper and buyers want to go up. So let's see if who wins the battle, right? But I feel that I want the buyers to win because I want buyers to reach at 894. So the next particular stock that we're going to be discussing is JFC. And what happened to JFC today, guys? It is a little... Oh, come on, right? So JFC, guys, you know this is a bear channel, okay? On Friday, it looks to me it tried here, then it stayed above here. So I was thinking, okay, these two levels are important. There should be some continuation. But what happened was it opened here, dropped the price, even retested it again. And we, although we found some buyers though, that is a little bit of a good sign. So tomorrow, this area here is important. We cannot break down at 193 and below, guys. If we break down around 192 and stay below there, then you know this is a micro channel. They may want to continue this particular down area to go back to exactly around 192, right? Which is not good. But if we stay above 193 and continue to go up above 194.50, then you know this is a continuation to the bull micro channel. That is the only way we're gonna look at it, because for me this area here, it's either we go above 195 or below 192. That is for this particular stock, guys. But if we take a look at the bigger picture, guys, it looks to me first entry, we have not even have a second entry, and looks like it's going down. So I don't want it to break here, this area here, because if it breaks here, then we know we may be continuing to a new bear micro channel here, which is not so great, guys. We want it to continue to go up to do one more round to the upside, right? That is for this particular stock, guys. The next stock that we're going to be discussing is MBT. And MBT again, guys, is going up even higher, which is good, guys. I like it because I think our target for this particular stock is around 56, around that area. So we still have some room to go up. Now for MBT, guys, remember this particular area, it's either this or this. Then it continued, and today it even went above and continued to above. Now tomorrow, I would say this particular area is important, right? So if we went down there around 49.40 and stay below there, then this could be a start of a bear micro channel. Now it does not mean bear micro channel is bad, but if we cannot break the low of today's candle, then we may still have a good sign that we can still go up. But other than that, I would say for this particular stock, we still have some room to go up, right? And how many days have we been not breaking any lows? Actually, it's only 5 days, which is mostly most of the stock, guys, which is overall good though, because we don't want to go back at 43 though. We want it to go back higher, right? And I think they may want to close this gap here around 52, around 54, to maybe reach this particular area. So that is good for this stock. And remember, MBT has a tendency to go straight up, up, up in a way though. So I'm pretty happy with this particular stock. And first entry second entry, and we're look like we're going up. So overall, we still have some upside potential. The next particular stock that we're going to be discussing is MM. Now, MM, guys, today was overall okay. Maybe not the greatest, but it's okay. So remember here, okay, so if we take a look at it on a smaller scale, like that, micro channel, take a look at this, one, two, then we have a micro channel to the upside, right? Although it tried to do a micro channel to the downside, if we're gonna take a look at it, right? Then from here, it went down, but it could not reach below 525 or 524. So basically, it's still a micro channel. It went up, up, and then today it went up. So that is good. Now, the only issue here tomorrow is that, okay, we know we have two price tomorrow that we're going to look at. It's either here or a little bit higher. So you know if it hits here and stay below 544, then you know this is a micro channel to the downside, right? Now if it stays above here, if it tries to go down, could not break this 544 and break 560, then you know it's a continuation to the micro channel to the upside. That is what I see for this particular stock, and it is still have some upward bias. That's what I feel. And because you know, basically from this particular market, if we make this one bigger, we already broken its IPO price at 450, and we actually at 1 peso above the IPO price, which is great. Can we continue? Yes, because we are on a new territory. We have never been there, right? That is good for this particular stock. The next stock that we're going to be discussing is my old favorite, PGOLD. And what's PGOLD doing? Overall, it is doing okay. Okay, I would say. Maybe not the greatest, but it's okay. Take a look at this, guys. See the market? It tried to go down but never retested 43.30, so it went up again. Then today it opened here, tried to go down around 43.80, and buyers found buyers, right? And then now, although we're trying to go back at 43.95, so tomorrow, basically, simple analysis here, if we can stay above at 43.80, guys, then you know there is a continuation to this bull micro channel. But if we went down here below 43.81, then I may be looking at 43.50. If we could not reach 43.50, then maybe we're still on a bull micro channel. So basically, I hope tomorrow we can stay above 43.81 and we can break the high, and we could even go reach higher than what price again? My goal is above 44.61, and if we can reach above 44.61, then we may be able to reach 47. And if we reach 47, I reach my goal to get out. Alright, that is for pure gold. And then the next particular stock that we're going to be discussing is SECB, guys. SECB today, guys, was...
I like it, I love it, I want some more of it.
For me, my biggest winner today is SECB. Although, actually, I was not able to buy SECB, but still... what happened was, remember this particular area, guys, okay? You got sellers again, then we started to see buyers, buyers. It could not retest this particular area. It tried so hard. Then you know buyers all got out all the way. And today, that means that there are no more sellers. All buyers, because the sellers have become buyers to get out. And that's why it all went up. So tomorrow, if there's a continuation, whereas I feel there is, we can't go below 119.46. And we could stay above here. For this particular stock is really beaten back. Because this stock used to be around 200, and now it became 80 or something like that. Wow, that's a big down there, guys. So of course, I feel that they may want to go back around 155. So there is still a very big room for this particular stock, guys. Now you may want to, if this goes down a bit on a micro channel level, then it may want to retest 115. And then from there, let's take a look at what happened, right? So for this particular stock, if it could not go below 119.50, then you know it's going to go continue to 122.50 and above. Now for our next particular stock is a very good example, tech. Now for tech, guys, it's again, I really like the micro channel technique because it's easy for us to see who is winning the battle. Now of course, take a look at this. So on Friday, if you would just done this particular area here, like if this breaks down, maintains here, then you know this is a start of a bear micro channel. So people here are, sellers here are pushing down the market, buyers are taking profit. That's why you would feel it goes down, right? But in this particular scenario, actually it was seller exiting. And you can see that because when it opens, sellers exit, and maybe some of them weren't able to exit, and they even tried to even go up higher, right? So for tomorrow, I would say we don't want to go back down to this level around 7. If we could go there, a little bit movement here. And if we go straight above, then there is a continuation to tech. Now, for this particular area, for tech, if we can clear the 527 zone, because this, basically, this is the start of the, remember this particular area? We did, once before, we were trying to use this one as a support, right? And this broke down. And now it could be that buyers from this particular area, which they bought down here, they may want to exit here. The reason for that being is that they already made money around 5 pesos, right? They may lose, they may have break even here, but they made money here going to this particular area. So the only way I can see that is that there could be some buyers, but if there's strong continuation, guys, this could even go as high as 10, right? So this may not be a very good area to buy, though. You may want it to pull back to around 638, then take a look at what happens, all right? But other than that, I feel that this market, although this market is going up to the higher, right? But because of this particular area, we could knock our head off here. So let's take a look at it tomorrow. So basically, guys, I'd like to thank you for another good day here, another good review. Now, I hope you would like and subscribe to my channel. And then if you want, you can please comment. If you want any new stuff for me to discuss, please feel free. I'll be happy to share what I know. And then if you have any position or something that you'd like me to discuss, I'll be happy to tell you what I think. But of course, I'm not recommending you to do whatever. It's all up to you. So thank you very much, and take care, and see you guys tomorrow.